and welcome to the latest installment of our virtual Family Saturdays here at the Bowdoin College Museum of Art. My name is Sinclaire Ledahl, and I am an education assistant in the museum. While we wish that you could be with us here in person, we are thrilled to be able to bring the museum to you through this virtual program. At the end of the video, I will lead a small craft activity that relates to the exhibit I'll be showing you today. Feel free to pause the video at any time to engage with your family and answer any questions I might pose. I'm standing in the exhibit, Innovation and Resilience Across Three Generations of Wabanaki Basketmaking, which was curated by students from Bowdoin's Native American Student Association, Amanda Cassano, Sunshine Eaton, and Shandine Largo. The exhibit features a range of baskets made by Wabanaki artists. Wabanaki means people of the Dawn Land and is the collective term for the indigenous communities in Maine, the Penobscot, Passamaquoddy, Abenaki, Mi'kmaq, and Maliseet. For Wabanaki communities, woven baskets have long been a source of economic empowerment, a means of resisting assimilation, and a form of individual artistic expression. Here is an example of a traditional woven basket. This basket is called a cake basket and would have been used to carry cakes, pies, napkins, and silverware. Even though it has a functional purpose, it's also crafted beautifully with tight, even weaving. What would you want to carry in a basket like this? Wabanaki baskets are typically made from the wood strips of the brown ash tree. These trees are incredibly important to Wabanaki people because of their role in Wabanaki creation stories. In these stories, the mythic hero Kaluskap shoots an arrow into the brown ash tree, and the Wabanaki people come into the world through a hole in the trunk. Because of its role in their creation, Wabanaki communities have a special relationship with the brown ash tree. When a tree is being prepared for basket weaving, the wood is pounded carefully and peeled away from the tree in strips. These strips can be made into smaller pieces, dyed, and woven into baskets like the ones you see here. These flexible pieces of wood can be twisted, bent, and delicately made into new shapes. Take a look at this basket by Geo Neptune. What kinds of techniques have they used to change the form of the ash wood? What other materials might they have used to create this colorful basket? What does the basket make you think about? This basket is connected to another Wabanaki creation story and is entitled Apiksilu Binds the Sun. In this part of the story, Apiksilu, a striped skunk, throws Kisus, the sunbird, into a world of darkness. Kaluskap, the same hero who brings the Wabanaki people into the world, frees the sunbird to bring the world back into balance. What elements of the story can you see in the basket? I see the sunbird on top of the basket, with golden elements like its wings and beads, but also the dark, deep purples of the basket itself make me think about a world without a sun. Within Wabanaki communities and families, basket-making techniques are passed down through generations. The techniques and styles stay relatively consistent over time, and new generations add their own personal touches to traditional styles. This generational knowledge is incredibly important to Wabanaki communities, who resist assimilation by keeping their traditional art forms strong. Take a look at this flower top basket by Molly Neptune Parker. Now, look at this flower top basket by her granddaughter, Frances Soktama. What has changed over time between the two artists? What is the same? Wabanaki basket making is still very much alive and evolving. However, this basket weaving tradition is in danger. The emerald ash borer, an invasive species of beetle, destroys ash trees, the primary material for these baskets. Beetle infestations can kill whole stands of ash trees, a tragedy that threatens the community's generational knowledge, because without materials to make baskets from, the knowledge of how to make these baskets may not be preserved. This is an urgent issue for indigenous groups, who are working together with local governments and scientists to create conservation plans to save the ash trees. We'll now move into a small craft activity where we can explore creating shapes out of a flat material, much like Wabanaki basket weavers do when they make baskets out of ash wood. For our activity today, we'll be using colored construction paper, scissors, and tape or glue. Let's start by cutting our construction paper into long strips. You can decide how wide you want your strips to be. I'm going to cut a few different colors of paper so I can make a more colorful basket. You can also think about what story you might want your basket to tell or what emotions you want it to make you feel when you choose your colors. Today, I'll be making a basket out of pink, red, and white paper. I'll show you a couple different methods for transforming these paper strips into other forms, but feel free to explore your own techniques. First, let's try weaving our strips of paper together. You can go over and under with the same color to create a checkerboard pattern or mix up your colors to make a more varied pattern. So I'm going to alternate my red and pink, and then maybe I'll go over and under with this piece of white paper, creating a little woven pattern. And I'll repeat that until I have a square or rectangle that's the size that I want my base to be. So from here, once we have a square or a rectangle, you can go ahead and fold the ends of the paper in to make sides that go up vertically. And then we can keep weaving around to make something that has both a bottom and sides. Take a look at this strawberry basket by Clara Neptune Kieser. Can you make something that looks like these loops? Here's another example by Vanessa Bryant-Frey. How can you make your paper look like the spikes or triangles on this basket? Here's an example of a form that I made using this method. I used my checkerboard at the bottom and then folded up the sides and added some fun handles and loop shapes on the sides of the basket. I hope you all enjoyed this craft today, and don't forget to share your finished products with the museum if you want to. Thank you so much for joining me today. We hope to see you in the museum in person soon to see more of the Wabanaki baskets on display, as well as our new Jonah Frank and Marsha Resnick exhibits. Thank you again for watching, and we hope to see you in the museum very soon.